Hey folks, I hope life is going great for you. Welcome to another Frontierndica video. Today we are going to talk about the goal of turning India into a Vishwaguru. For those who may not be native speakers of Hindi, the term Vishwaguru literally just means world leader. Proponents of this goal harken back to the civilizational might of ancient India, which was not just the world's largest economy, but was advanced over all other nations and peoples in science, philosophy, mathematics, spirituality, and many other spheres. But alas, centuries of loot, rapine, and extractive exploitation, both by foreign governments and native ones, have reduced us to a weak and vulnerable country at the world stage. The current BJP government at the center keeps indicating from time to time that their vision is to make amends and vault India back to Vishwaguru status. Now, this video is not going to be about critiquing the performance of the Modi government in trying to achieve this goal. That is a subject for another time. But rather, in this video, we're going to look at why the objective of turning India into a superpower must not just remain relegated to the realm of political rhetoric, but must be treated as a goal necessary for the very survival of our civilization. First of all, we need to understand that the global order is changing very rapidly. The undisputed hegemony which the United States has enjoyed for almost three decades is beginning to come to an end. China, which is already a bigger economy than the US by purchasing power parity GDP, will also overtake the latter in nominal terms in a short few years. The current COVID crisis has only accelerated these trends, as the economic damage to China has been relatively minor compared to the havoc that has been wrought upon the US. What all of this means is that the US no longer has the capacity to unilaterally intervene and stop conflicts across the world. Its willingness and capabilities to be the planet's policeman are both on the wane. Meanwhile, India, being an economy just a fifth the size of China's, is unable to modernize its military at the pace necessary to seriously face the possibility of a two-front war. Even in the face of recurring Chinese incursions and belligerence at our border, we are forced to wait until the last minute before responding in kind. This is exactly what occurred in the Galwan Valley as well, where we finally only reacted when the Chinese deception had become all too obvious. What's more, even with the recent Atmanirbhar Bharat project, the banning of several Chinese apps, and calls to boycott Chinese products, it is obvious that there are simply too many products and services which we have no option but to currently import from China. This is one field where the aspiration of being a global superpower must be strongest. Barely 10 to 15 years ago, China was just seen as a cheap labor country with lax workers' protections, ideal only for building simple, low-cost products. But now China is at the forefront of many new technological advances, such as automation, fintech, drones, 5G, machine learning, etc., etc. In its poor third world state, India will remain dependent on foreign powers like China, the US, and European countries for the latest tech to power its economy and its military. And this will make sure that India remains at their mercy and does not have any strategic autonomy. What's more, if India is to become even a reasonably prosperous country, let's say a nominal per capita GDP between 15,000 and 20,000 USD at some point in the future, that itself would necessitate propelling the size of the Indian economy beyond the GDP of the US or China today. Even if said goal is achieved decades from now, it would still mean India would be standing roughly shoulder to shoulder with these two powers, not to mention the European Union. If India does not reach this state of development, then it would mean that it has gotten stuck in the middle income trap with an aging population, stagnant economic growth, and changing internal religious demographics. All of these will become a toxic cocktail for the state to survive unscathed. Furthermore, if India does not reach superpower status, it'll find it extremely difficult to take the sort of harsh but necessary measures which China has taken against ethnic separatists and religious fundamentalists. India will not be able to forcibly integrate its minorities as long as it can still be bullied by other countries at the world stage. To combat its existential problems, India must, seriously aim for Vishwaguru status, or at least to become a close number 2 or number 3 superpower. With that, we'll wrap this episode up, guys. Hope you enjoyed watching this video. Do subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to stay updated.